as the day panted for the water, so my soul longed after thee. You alone are my heart's desire, and I long to worship thee.
As the day sing it again.
Yeah.
want you more than gold or silver. Sing,
I want you more than gold or silver. Only you can satisfy.
You are love,
you are love, I love you. You're a giver and yes, full of my eyes.
You are love,
you are love, all my strength, and my shield.
Oh, to you
alone may my spirit
live.
Hey!
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Let us go to God in prayer. Gracious and loving God, we give you thanks for new mercies this day. We thank you, O God, that you afforded us another day in your presence. Another day where we can come into your house to worship you and to praise your holy name. God, we thank you for all that you have done for us this past week. We thank you for the doors you opened and the doors that you shut. We thank you, O God, for your protection and your provision. We thank you, O God, for your abiding presence. We remember your promise where you said you would never leave us or forsake us. And so, God, we come mindful of the fact that you're a faithful God. You're a mighty Father. You're everlasting. You are the Alpha and the Omega. We recognize, O God, that if it wasn't for your grace and your mercy, we would not be here today. And so, God, we thank you. We bless you. And we lift you up. And we glorify you. And we pray, O God, that as we worship you today, that you will feel that we indeed are worshiping you in spirit and truth. And we can only do that by the power of your Holy Spirit. So send your Holy Spirit. Send your Spirit to rest upon each and every person under the sound of my voice, so that the worship that we will give will be pleasing in your sight. Lord God, you are our strength. You are our rock. And you are the one that redeems our lives. And we pray in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord, church. Come on, shall we praise God? Amen. Jesus loves you, and so do I. Amen. Our opening hymn is Faith of Our Fathers. Please pay attention to the monitors for the words.
Fire of God, turn fire.
Praise the Lord. Amen. Let us continue with our call to worship. Come, worship the Lord in the beauty of His holiness.
His steadfast love endures forever.
Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for He is good.
His steadfast love endures forever.
Let the redeemed of the Lord say,
His steadfast love endures forever.
Praise Him. Amen. The gospel reading this morning is taken from the book of Mark, chapter 4, verses 35 to 41. And I will read for your hearing. Amen?
Amen.
On that day, when the evening had come, He said to them, "Let us go across to the other side." And leaving the crowd behind, they took Him with them in the boat, just as He was. Other boats were with Him. A great windstorm arose, and the waves beat into the boat, so that the boat was already being swamped. But He was in the stern, asleep on the cushion, and they woke Him up and said to Him, "Teacher, do you not care that we are perishing?" He woke up and rebuked the wind and said to the sea, "Peace, be still." Then the wind ceased, and there was a dead calm. He said to them, "Why are you afraid? Have you still no faith?" And they were filled with great awe and said to one another, "Who then is this that even the wind and the sea obey him?" This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Oh,
God a big wave. Hallelujah. Just wave your hands and say, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Praise God. At this time, you may be seated. I would like to take this opportunity first to welcome each and everyone to service this morning. It's really good to see you in the house of God. Amen. And if you are worshiping with us for the very first time, would you wave your hands in the air like you don't care so that we can see you and recognize you? Praise God. All family in the house, it's really good to see you in the house this morning. Praise God. In terms of our announcements, our summer worship schedule will be in effect from July 4th to August 9th. And that means... August 29th. I'm seeing things. So that means that church service begins at 10 a.m. July 4th to August 29th. Service begins at 10 a.m. Okay, please mark your calendars. Morning prayer service begins July 6th at 6 a.m. every Tuesday going forward from 6 a.m. until 6:30 a.m. for 30 minutes. Praise God. Sunday school teachers training will be on July 31st. And that's a Saturday morning at 11 a.m. Amen. Sunday school teachers training will be July 31st. Please save the date. And there is a Bible study sign-up sheet to my left on this table for our new studies that's coming up. The deadline to sign up for our new book is July 4th. Amen. So you please sign up. The book costs only $20. You can pay for the book as soon as possible today, and as soon as you know you have it, so we will have the book to study. And online payment is an option for everything now. I love it. I don't know about you. I think it's really good. It's easy. Money goes right into church's bank. And to do Zelle, it's by Zelle. It's Union United BKLY at gmail.com. So if you use that address in your checking account, you'll be able to pay your tithes, your offerings, you can pay for the book, anything at all through Zelle. It's a great, convenient way so that even if we travel on vacation, we can still meet our obligations for our tithes and offerings. Amen? Amen. Amen. Praise God. I love it. You don't have to buy checks anymore, because we now have that. At this time, we'll have our church covering prayer. It's prayer time, church. You can come to the altar and kneel if you wish to. With social distancing, you can stand where you are, kneel where you are. But this is the time to come and bring your petitions to God. And when you get up and you leave, leave them there. Amen? Sister Cheryl Cranmore will cover us this morning. Is Sister Cheryl here? Yes. Praise God.
Through it all. Through it all. I learned to trust in Jesus. I learned to trust in God. Through it all. Upon his word.
We come before your throne of grace this morning, O God, asking for your mercies, O God. Father God, we bring our petitions before you, O God. Lord God, we surrender ourselves to you. We surrender our desires to you. We surrender our needs and our wants to you today, O God, because you and you alone are God. You are worthy of all honor, all praise, O God, and all glory. And we say, Lord God, thank you. Thank you, O God, for this day, O God, for this is the day that you have made, O God. And we are rejoicing, Lord God, and giving thanks today because you didn't have to wake us up. You didn't have to call our names today, O God. Lord God, and we thank you. We thank you because you are almighty. You are worthy, O God, Father God. We forgive us, O God, for all our trespasses, O God. Father God, anything that is in us that is unlike you, O God, we ask you, O God, to remove it, O God. Lord, we surrender ourselves to you, O God. Come, O God, take full and complete control of our lives, O God. Take complete control of this service here to you today, O God. O God, we honor you. We love you. We reverence you. We worship you, O God. Father God, use us, O God, for your glory, O God. Use us for your kingdom, Lord God. Father God, touch all the sick, O God, amongst us, O God. Touch those that are in your nation, around your world, that are sick and shut in, O God. Father God, touch them with your oh Jesus, O God. Oh God, touch them with your healing balm, Lord. Touch them with your healing balm. Touch us, O God. Oh, Father God, touch us with your healing balm. Touch us, Lord. Oh, God, we surrender to you, oh, God. We surrender all to you. Lord God, so we surrender the choir to you. Oh, God, such an awesome ministry, oh, God. Oh, God, use them, oh, God. Use them, oh, God. Use them, Lord. Father God, we surrender all the ministries of this church. Oh, God, UMW, oh, God. Father God, the men's ministry, oh, God. Father God, it's all the things that are coming up, oh, God, before us in this new season, oh God. Father God, we ask you to bless it, oh God. Because God, if it's not blessed by you, it cannot go forward, oh God. Father God, we ask you the food ministry, oh God. Oh God, bless it, Lord God. Oh Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord God, we thank you for your blessings. We thank you for your mercies, oh God. Oh God, we thank you. Father God, this nation, Lord God, this nation, Father God, you know of all the things that are going on around the world, oh God. Oh, Father God, cover your nation. Cover your people, oh God. Watch over your people, oh God. Lord, your word said that if your people who are called by your name shall humble themselves and pray and turn from their wicked ways, oh God, that they will see your face and you will heal the land, oh God. Father God, we asking you for healing. We asking you, oh God, go by in the hospitals, in the nursing homes, in the hospices, oh God. Father God, touch, Lord God. Let your healing balm, oh God, rise and touch everyone, oh God. Father God, we thank you. Father God, all our cares we leave before you today, oh God. Father Father God, watch over the President, President Biden. Oh God, Kamala Harris. Oh God, Vice President. Oh God, Father God, Chuck Schumer. Oh God, Father God, all the people that are going up for election this election Tuesday and these days ahead here. Oh God, Father God, touch them. Oh God, and put the right people in right places. Oh God, yes, so that God. Oh God, the injustices of the world can come to an end. Oh God, Father God, we need you, Lord. We need you. We need you more than ever before. Oh God. Oh Father God, thank you. Thank you for everything that you've done so far. Oh God, and everything that you will continue to do. Oh God. Oh Father God, because your word, oh God, is a lamp unto our feet. Oh God, and a light unto our path. Lord God. Oh Father God, thank you. Thank you for this awesome opportunity, oh God, to give glory and honor to your name, oh God, in this format, oh God. Lord God, I thank you because you and you alone are worthy. You and you alone are worthy of the honor, the praise, oh God, and the glory. Father God, if there's anything that I forget, don't forget Pastor right now, oh God, Father. Father God, touch her, oh God, from the crown of her head to the sole of her feet, oh God. Father God, let this word that come forth from her mouth, oh God, let it be all upon you, oh God. Let it be of you and on you, oh God. Help it to be a blessing to all of us, oh God, in this sanctuary and beyond, oh God. We thank you in Jesus' precious name. Amen and amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. You may rise and return to your seats. Thank you, Sister Cheryl. May God continue to bless Sister Cheryl in her ministry. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Come on, give God a praise. Give God a praise. God is good. Hallelujah. We give God thanks and thank God for our wonderful pastors. At this time, please stand on your feet, give God a praise, and welcome Pastor to the pulpit again.
Praise the Lord, church. You may be seated. I have one announcement I want to add to Sister Jackie's. Two, actually. I want to say Happy Father's Day to all the fathers. We pray God's blessing on you, and as you continue on this journey called life, that you'll continue to be faithful to the God who has given you the privilege of being a father. Happy Father's Day. And I know some of the women who think they're fathers too want to be included. So happy Father's Day to the mothers who are mothers and fathers. Amen. I got a letter from the Local Development Corporation of Crown Heights. I'll put this letter on the door by my office door so that you can read it at your leisure. But I just want to highlight what it's about. It's about affordable housing. And so if you're looking for affordable housing, they're saying that there's a lottery that will soon be enacted, where they will be having apartments from studios to three bedrooms in the Bedford Union Armory development. This is located on President Street in Brooklyn. So they will launch it pretty soon. And this will give you some more information. It came a bit late because they were having a workshop as to how to apply, but that took place on June 3rd. But you can still contact the Local Development Corporation if you're looking for affordable housing. So those are all the announcements I have at this time. Let us stand as we affirm that we are a tithing church. We are a tithing church because the Word of God teaches tithing. Our experience gives witness to tithing. Our obedience to God requires tithing.
So let us bring our tithes and offerings to the Lord, and the Lord has prospered us. For the hand shall be holy unto him.
So come, if you haven't given on Zelle, come and bring your offerings to God, for the Lord loves a cheerful giver. Joy to see our young people being active in praising and worshiping God. Give him another. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Let us dedicate this offering to God. Oh, gracious and loving God, you're so generous to us. We thank you for giving us all that we would ever need. But most of all, we thank you for your Son, Jesus Christ, who came and lived and died that we might have life and have it more abundantly. So God, we come giving back to you what you've already given us. We ask that you would bless these gifts, O God, and that you would bless us and use us and our gifts to further extend your gospel here in Crown Heights. God, have your way. Bless your people, for we pray with thanksgiving. Amen.
Praise God.
Seated as we invite our music minister and the choir to lead us in song.
Is risen from the dead. That Christ is risen from the dead. You shall be saved.
Shall be saved. You shall be saved.
Master, the tempest, look out, it's raging, and the billows, they're tossing mighty high. The sky, no, 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 no shelter is nigh. Carest thou not that we perish? Tell me how can thou when it seems like each moment so madly is threatening a grave, in the angry deep. When all you got to do is say, the winds and the waves shall obey thy will. If you say, peace be still, peace be still, oh, peace be still, peace be still, the winds and every wave shall obey thy will. sweetly they'll obey. They'll obey his will if he says, peace be still. Peace be still. Oh, peace be still. Peace be still. Whether the rafts or the storm-tossed sea or demons or men or whatever may be, no water can swallow.
Sister Francine for blessing us.
Thank you, choir.
For blessing us today. Thank you. Peace be still. God is good, church. Today, I want to talk about defining moments. Defining moments are moments that when they occur, they change your life. They change the direction of your life. And they really are moments that are God moments. They are moments when God is active and at work, ordering the course of your life. And this boat ride was one of those defining moments. What started out as a little getaway from the crowds on the seashore, really it was a lake on the lake shore, for some much needed respite and regrouping, suddenly became a boat ride that threatened the lives of all those who were on board. And it brought to mind a boat ride that I had gone on a couple of years ago. I won't call any names or anything, but I was on a boat ride that had me praying overtime. I was calling on my God to save this boat that I was on. And many of my companions were doing the same, because we surely thought that we were in danger of losing our very lives. But God was good to us, and we are here today to tell the tale. (Clears throat)
Let us pray. God, speak a word that will bless our lives, a word that will challenge us, a word that will inspire us. Speak your word, not mine, and may the words be a blessing to all who will hear. For you, O Lord, are our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. So according to the text, a great windstorm arose, and the waves beat into the boat, so that the boat was already being swamped. This body of water where the incident took place is called Lake Genesaret, and it's a large body of water. It's not very deep, and it's known for violent storms. Storms that appear suddenly and do damage and then it's gone. People say that it's because of where it's located, that it's between the mountains. And so when the wind gets in there, it goes like a whirlwind. And so a storm can arise quickly and change everything. And that's what happened that day with Jesus and his disciples. And isn't that what happens to us? Because this storm is like a metaphor for the hardships that we sometimes encounter in life. Life is going good, and then all of a sudden, it comes at you from where? We don't know sometimes. And when we are hit by these storms in life, we too become unsteady. We feel as if we are going to drown. We are feeling overwhelmed, and we often cry out to God because we believe that if we are in this hardship, it means that God is not paying attention. It means that God has probably turned to someone else, and we believe that it's because God doesn't care. And the disciples ran to Jesus and woke him up and said, "Don't you care that we are perishing?" And they became fearful for their lives. They felt as if they were going to drown and Jesus would not rescue them. If they had read the prophet Isaiah's writing, they would have known that it was impossible for Jesus not to care. Because the prophet Isaiah spoke these words to the people of Israel who were exiled in Babylon. They were in their own storm, and he says to them, "But now, thus says the Lord, he who created you, O Jacob, he who formed you, do not fear, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name, you are mine." And he went on to say that when you pass through the waters, I will be with you. And through the rivers, they shall not overwhelm you. So whatever you might be facing, whatever your storm might be, know that it will not take you out. It will not overwhelm you. It will not cause you to drown, because God cares. And so the disciples learned a lesson in God's ability to care. And that's why I said, every time you face a defining moment, it's a moment where God shows up. If you're looking, you will see. If you're listening, you will hear. And so the people in the boat, they got to see how God cares. But Isaiah, when he was talking about this God who cares, he was also referencing their exile when they were coming out of their slavery in Egypt. He was referencing how God brought them to the Red Sea and brought them through the Red Sea. He was saying to them, "Don't just look at your exile in Babylon. Look at what happened with your ancestors when they were in Egypt, how God brought them out. And those people, those ancestors, they too thought that God did not care. It's a human condition. When we're in a hard place, we automatically think that it's because God doesn't care. Because if God cared, he wouldn't let this happen. Don't we say that? We say that when we are in a hard place. And so the people of Israel, when they were brought out of Egypt, and God directed Moses to lead them to the Red Sea, they turned around and they said, well, why? Why did you bring us here to die? Weren't there enough graves in Egypt? They thought that they were going to die. They did not know that the God who had brought them out was going to lead them through, that he was going to make a way where there was no way, that he was going to roll back the sea and they were going to be able to walk through on dry land. Friends, that's the God we serve. That's the God that makes me want to dance and shout, because he can do the impossible when there seems to be no way out. And so that's the God, that's the reputation of the God that we serve. And that's the God that was in that boat that day that showed up in the person of Jesus. So let us look at the defining moments in this text. Three of them I want to point out. The first defining moment was when Jesus said to them, let's go over to the other side. He was directing that move. He said to them, let's go over. Now they were close to the shore because he had been teaching the people about the kingdom of God, and the people were on the shore, and when the crowd became too large, he got into the boat and was teaching them from the boat. And so he says, let us go across. And they obeyed. He instructed them and they followed through. Now, as they were going, all was well until the storm arose. And then they were in danger of losing their lives. By obeying Jesus, they found themselves in danger. I want you to hear that. Beloved, when we live according to God's will, and we go where God sends us, it does not mean that we will not face hardship. It doesn't mean that it will be smooth sailing. But it means that whatever you encounter, God is there with you and he'll see you through. Whatever you face, God will be with you. And that's why we have to be certain that we are in the will of God. Because God knew that the seas were going to get rough. And he already made provision. Amen? The Apostle Paul knew this too. He was writing to the church at Corinth and he said, as servants of God, we have commended ourselves in every way through great endurance, in afflictions, in hardships, imprisonments, beatings, riots, sleepless nights, and hunger. 2 Corinthians 6, verse 4 to 5. So, doing God's will does not give us a pass, a free ride to hardships. Sometimes God will send us to places outside of our comfort zone. And yes, we will face challenges, but with God in our boat, we will be able to overcome. God will speak to the winds, and God will speak to the waves of adversity. And what he will say, peace, be still. Be still. The second defining moment in this text, it's when they woke him up and said to him, teacher, do you not care that we are perishing? If God cares, we ask, how is this disease taking over my body? If God cares, how is it that I am not able to do the things I used to do? Why is my energy not there? Why am I not remembering what I ought to remember? If God cares, why am I unemployed? Why I just can't seem to come out of debt? We ask ourselves these questions. If God cares, how is it that He's allowing these things to happen? Why did my loved one die? Why didn't God say, do something? Thankfully, the disciples had the good sense to wake Jesus. They called Him teacher, because that's how they saw Him. They saw Him as a rabbi who had words of wisdom and words of revelation about God. And in that moment, they cried out, teacher, do you not care that we are perishing? But in that moment when Jesus woke up, they saw something else. He wasn't just teacher in that moment. He was God in person. He was the powerful God who spoke to the winds and the waves. They saw more than a teacher. And so it is with us in God moments. When God shows up and does the impossible, we are given a glimpse of God in His power and in His might, and the God who can heal and deliver, and we are left with no words. No words. Because God demonstrated to us in our time of crisis and need that He is the omnipotent. And I remember a particular incident. I had just gotten accepted into seminary, and I would traverse that George Washington Bridge almost every other week. I would go from Jersey to Connecticut. And one day I was heading back to Jersey, and a tractor trailer came at my right side and took out from the front passenger door all the way back to the bumper. And I was so shaken up. And you know what? He didn't stop. And when I got off that bridge and I pulled over, and after the shaking stopped, I said, wow, what a God I serve, because He protected me. I did not get a scratch on my body. And when I took my car to the mechanic shop, he said, you know, it's amazing that you did not get hurt. He said, in the condition that your car is in, I don't know even know why the insurance is going to fix it. They would have scrapped that car with some other companies. And I said, wow, in God amazing. The God I serve protected me. And I was doing God's business. I was trying to study to show myself approved for the task that I now do. And so I say that to say that even when we're in God's will, we're going to have hardships. We're going to find ourselves in danger. But the God who has taken us to that place or that situation will get us through it. And we'll see that He is more than just a God in heaven. He's a God who is right here with us, watching over us and guiding us. But I want to go on to talk about the third defining moment. He woke up and rebuked the wind and said to the sea, peace, be still. Then the wind ceased and there was a dead calm. Jesus speaks a word of command to the wind, and He tells the sea, to be still. That's a defining moment, friends. Those in the other boat, because the text says other boats were with them, they missed seeing the divine manifestation of God. They missed seeing God's power displayed. They missed being witnesses to an awe-inspiring moment. A moment when a human who was fully human and fully God got up and spoke to the wind and the sea. On seeing Jesus' power over the cosmos, the disciples asked themselves this question: who then is this that even the wind and the sea obey him? Who then is this? They were perplexed that this man who was with them, who taught them, and who was sleeping prior to being awakened, was able to calm a storm. And this question that they asked, I can imagine what was going through their minds. This is not just a rabbi who knew the scriptures well, or a prophet who predicted things to come. Neither was he just a godly man who was gifted to heal people. This man spoke to the wind and the waves, and they obeyed him. This was no ordinary man. This was God incarnate. This man, friends, was able to calm the elements. Friends, when we face challenges sometimes, we get to see this God. This God we get to see. In Thomas's life, the disciple Thomas, he experienced this God. Remember when Jesus resurrected and he went to the crowd and Thomas wasn't there, and when he was told, he said he wouldn't believe until he saw that this body was the body that had been on the cross. And then Jesus showed up and calls Thomas and said, put your hand in my side, feel, see my wounds. And Thomas responded when he did that. He said, my Lord and my God. He no longer doubted. He believed. That was a defining moment for him. When we see God's power displayed in our lives and the lives of people around us, we too are in awe of God's power and God's might. We too are able to say in our minds, who is this? Who is this? This God that shows up and does mighty things. And that causes us to be in awe of God. If you're not in awe of God, something is not kosher, something is not right. Something needs to be checked out. Just to think about all that he has already done, all he has created for our benefit, all that he does. You want to think about God in an awesome way? Think about the body, the human body, how he created it, all the cells that he put together. Some people attribute it to science, but science is now studying God's handiwork. That's what science does. God created amazing, awesome things, beautiful things. And when we think on those things, we ought to be in awe of him. That day, the disciples' lives were changed. That day, they decided that this was no ordinary man and that they were going to continue to follow him. That day, their faith increased. That day, they became more confident in the God that they were serving. That day was a defining day for them. And they looked at Jesus differently after that. Friends, don't wait for a storm to come. Don't wait for challenges and difficulties to come. Look at what God is doing and has already done. And see who He is and decide to put your faith and trust in Him. Look at Him as the God of power and might, the I Am, the Great One, the One who can move mountains and still storms. Begin to see God now for the One that He truly is, the One who can bring order to your life. Storms will come. That's a given. Storms will come. But if you already got God in your boat, you can weather the storms. Storms will come. The other boats, I don't know who they were calling on for help. The other boats, they didn't see and hear what Jesus did. So they were at a disadvantage. They benefited from the calm, but they did not get to witness to the power of God. So it pays to have God in your boat, because when the storms come, you will know that God cares, and you will know that you can call on Him and He will rescue you. You will know that the adversities, even though they might be overwhelming, they cannot drown you. God with power will show up for you, but you gotta have Him in your boat. The song says, with Christ in our vessels, we can smile at the storms. Our God has proven time and time again that if He brings us to the storm, He will take us through the storm. As I close, I want to affirm that God cares for each and every one of us. He cares more than we can ever know. He cares for us so much that He encamps round about us. And when we face danger, He is there to see us through. And He can silence the wind and the waves and bring about a calm. Today, I speak to every storm that you might be going through. I say, peace be still in the name of Jesus. I say, know that God cares for you and that God will see you through every storm that you will ever encounter. Just remember that you've got to invite Him into your boat. Amen. Let us pray. God of the wind and the waves, God of might and power, we thank You for Your word. We thank You, O God, that we are given the confidence to know that You are with us and that Your grace and Your mercy will follow us. That when we face storms, that You are there to speak peace, be still to the wind and the waves. God, we thank You and we bless You for Your faithfulness. And for those of us who have not invited You yet into our boat, into our lives, we invite You now. We say, God, come. Come and journey with us. We repent of our sins and we seek to live in unity with Your Holy Spirit so that You will be the God who will walk beside us and the God who will see us through. And we give thanks and we praise You and we bless Your holy name. Amen. Church, would you stand as we
bring our worship to a close.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and
receive the benediction. Grow in confidence, knowing that God goes with you, knowing that He will walk with you through all the storms of life, knowing that He cares. Now, may the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of His Holy Spirit may rest, remain, and abide with you this day and forevermore. Amen. Amen.